the scripture as it is written. So it says, and if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? They're going to appear in that mainstream, in that lake of fire. Let's go to Ezekiel, the 18th chapter. Because it's not too late. The Lord's desire for you is not that you should die. But make no mistake about it, he will kill you. He not only has power to kill the body, but then cast you into hell. Kill you again, that second death. Remember we read about it in Luke, the 12th chapter, the 4th and 5th verse. So Ezekiel, the 18th chapter, reads as follows. And this is verse 30. Verse 29. Yes, said the house of Israel, the way of the Lord is not equal. O house of Israel, are not my ways equal? Are not your ways unequal? Okay? So they had this mindset of judgment that was unrighteous. Verse 30. Therefore, I will judge you, O house of Israel, everyone according to his ways, said the Lord God. So you're not going to die for what your father did, and the son, and the father's not going to die for what the son did. You're going to die for what you do, and you're going to live if you are obedient, if you fear God, the beginning of knowledge, if you had a wisdom to walk in his ways. Verse 31. Or verse 30, excuse me. Therefore, I will judge you, house of Israel, everyone according to his ways, saith the Lord. Repent and turn yourselves from all your transgressions so iniquity shall not be in your ruin. So the Lord is saying, hey, look, repent. Repent while you still have a chance. Tomorrow is not promised. We hear that all the time, but it's so true. Verse 31, cast away from you all your transgressions, all your sins, cast them away, whereby ye have transgressed, and make you a new heart and a new spirit, for why will ye die, O house of Israel? Here he was talking to Israel, but it goes for everybody. We all need, if you have not repented, you need to repent and walk in newness of life. Turn from your wicked ways. Be baptized in the name of Jesus. Start walking in accordance to his laws, his statutes, and his commandments. Verse 32, for I have no pleasure in the death of him that dieth, saith the Lord God. Wherefore turn yourselves and live ye. He has no pleasure in the death of him that dieth, but again, make no mistake about it, he will kill you. He will kill you. You see, we die every day. We die every day. From hunger, I think it's approximately 29,000 people that die from hunger every day. And death came because of sin. So we see what the fruits of sin is. It's death. We see that. That's the consequence. And he has told us in his word, look, you need to get it together. I'm going to kill you again. This is the message to mankind. Your whole duty is to fear God and keep his commandments. Let's go to Hebrews, the 10th chapter. Hebrews, the 10th chapter, because Paul here makes an excellent point. It says, in the 26th verse, for if we sin willfully after that we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remain no more sacrifices for sin. See, Jesus is not going to come back and die for you again. He died one time, okay, for sins that are past. And if you go against what he said knowingly and willingly and just disregard totally what the Lord has done for you, then this is what you got coming. He says, there remaineth no more sacrifices for sins, but a certain fearful looking for of judgment and fiery indignation, which shall devour the adversaries. Okay? So that's what you got coming. Verse 28, he that despised Moses' law died without mercy under two or three witnesses. That was a terrible death to be stoned to death. 29, how much sore punishment suppose ye shall he be thought worthy who hath trodden underfoot the Son of God and hath counted the blood of the covenant wherewith he was sanctified an unholy thing and hath done despite unto the Spirit of grace. See, you got to walk this path until the end. He that endureth to the end shall be saved. See, this is not a sprint, this is a marathon. And you have to endure. And he says, hey, look, you got something worse coming than being stoned. A much sore punishment. It is the lake of fire. When you trod underfoot the Son of God's blood, he came and died for you, died for me when we were yet in our sins. For you to sin again after you know the truth, for you to sin and walk away from God, you have a sore punishment coming. 30. For we know him that hath said, vengeance belongeth unto me, I will recompense, saith the Lord. And again, the Lord shall judge his people. See, there's another side of the Lord. That, yes, the Lord is loving, the Lord is merciful, but the Lord is also a man of war. The Lord also has vengeance, that is, he has wrath that's going to be poured upon the whole earth. And it's coming. And then he's going to be putting people in the lake of fire. Verse 31, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. God is not a joke. God is not something to be played with. God is a being to be reverenced and feared. I thank you for your time.